Hi, it's Pastor Jeff, and I'd like to talk to you today about another facet of healing hope, another attribute of holy healing hope. You see, friends, if you are going to have and hold on to God's holy healing hope, you must first come to realize the need for holy healing hearing. Hearing. That's right. I want to talk to you today about the hearing of healing hope. How hope hears, which leads to holy healing. You see, if you're going to have holy healing hope, you must first hear the gracious call of our Lord. The gospel has at its core this holy healing hope. And at the very beginning of that holy healing hope comes not just a humility of heart, but a hearing of the heart. That if you will do or should have this holy healing hope, friends, you first got to understand the need to hear and heed the word of God. Not just as is laid out in the scriptures, but the very voice of the God who still speaks. You see, the God who spoke still speaks, and those who are going to hold to healing hope, they're going to hear Almighty God say, "You must be born again." They're going to hear our holy God say, "You must repent and believe to be one who will be brought into the very family, the very bosom of God." Holy healing hope has this divine hearing. I say divine because it's a part of the miraculous gift of God. So many are able to listen to God's truth, but they don't hear him. Like Jesus said, so many are able to see, but yet they don't see. Here again, there are many who listen to the truth but never hear the truth, capital T. Holy healing hope has divine hearing. It's a gift from God. It's a part of healing hope. And I pray on this day that you have heard me rightly as I share with you a part of the gospel's core truth. I pray that what you've heard you'll respond to with a righteous hearing that embraces the grace of God, the call to repent and believe, which then if you've heard and hold to this healing hope, this holy healing hope, will be followed up with a obedience that brings glory to God. Amen and amen.